In this video, we're computing the density of a submerged rock given the tension in the string that's holding it up and the known mass of the rock. And the key to this problem is to use Archimedes' principle. So we're going to start in part A by just getting the size of the buoyant force on the rock. And we do that with a vertical force analysis. So we've got three forces acting vertically on this rock. One of them is just the tension in the string. I'm going to call that T. And we know that's 18.5 newtons. The other upward force on the rock is the buoyant force caused by the displaced fluid in this container. And that's water, by the way. And then the third force is the force of gravity acting down on this rock. And because this rock is just sitting there in equilibrium, these three forces must balance out. So I can write that T, the tension in the string, plus FB, the buoyant force, is equal to MG, the weight. This immediately gives us the size of the buoyant force on this rock. The buoyant force is mg minus t. And now we just have to plug numbers in. So the mass of the rock is 2.5 kilograms. The approximate value of g is 9.8 meters per second squared. And the given tension in the string is 18.5 newtons. And when we run the numbers on this, we get exactly 6 newtons for the size of the buoyant force. Now in part B, we want to calculate the density of the rock. And just a quick reminder here on the definition of density. So we use the Greek letter rho for that. And the density of the rock is going to be the mass of the rock, that's big M, divided by the volume of the rock. And the buoyant force is related to the volume of the rock because Archimedes' principle tells us that the buoyant force is equal to the weight of the fluid that's been displaced as we submerge the rock. So by applying Archimedes' principle, we should be able to nail down what the volume of the rock is. Then we plug into the density formula and we've got our answer. So again, just quoting Archimedes' principle here, the buoyant force is the weight of displaced fluid. So we need the mass of the water that's been pushed out of the way as the rock submerged. And so we know the volume of water that got pushed out of the way is equal to the volume of the rock. If we multiply that by the density of the water, so rho H2O, that gives us the mass of the water that's been pushed out of the way because density times volume gives you mass. So now we have the mass of the displaced water and we multiply by g so that we get mg for the water that was displaced. And that's the weight of the displaced fluid. So we can go ahead and solve symbolically for the volume of the rock. The volume of the rock is going to be the buoyant force, which we computed in part A, divided by the density of water times g. Now we can just sub in all these numbers, and I have 6 newtons for the buoyant force, approximately 1,000 kilograms per cubic meter for the density of water, and approximately 9.8 meters per second squared for the acceleration of gravity. When I run these numbers, I end up with 6.122 times 10 to the negative fourth cubic meters for the volume of this rock. Now I had a lot of students who thought this number just seemed too small. But keep in mind, a cubic meter is a block 1 meter on a side, and a typical little river cobble is very small in comparison to a cubic meter. So now we can finally finish our calculation. We have the density of the rock should be the mass of the rock, that was 2.5 kilograms, divided by the volume of the rock, which is this relatively small number, because we're talking about relatively large volume units. And when I run the numbers and round to our traditional 3 significant digits, I get 4,080 kilograms per cubic meter. And we've got the density of the rock by using Archimedes' principle. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.